Are you getting the same graph?
Yes, I'm getting the same. Sir, would the amplitude be -4 or 4?
Amplitude is going to be 4.
Okay.
Amplitude is taken as a distance between the from the mean position, which is this.
Yeah.
Till top. Okay. So over here, the amplitude is going to be 4.
Okay.
Do you have any query till here? Do you realize that the period of 10 graph is 180 degree?
What's that?
So the period of sine and cosine graph is always 360 degree.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, and for 10 theta is it's going to be 180 degree. So that's why I've done 180 divided by the value of B, that is 3.
Oh, okay.
So 180 and 360 degree.
Okay. Sir, for the first one, will it become 2 sine 3x minus 1?
Are you referring to question number 2, part A?
Yeah, the first part.
For the first part, you are going to convert cot x into cos 3x over sine 3x. Okay.
Okay.
And then you're going to multiply this. So 2 cos 3x sine 3x minus cos 3x equals to 0. Then you can take cos 3x common. 2 cos 2 sine 3x minus 1 equals to 0. We are also going to alter the angle. 3x is going to be greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 90 times 3 is 270 degree.
Okay.
Okay. So, yeah. Cos 3x equals to 0 and 2 sin 3x minus 1 is equals to 0. We are going to look for the angles from here as well as from here. Have you solved it or are you solving it?
I'm solving it right now.
Okay. Yes. Please take your time.
For the first one, is it 0? And for the second one, 10 and 50?
Yes, 10 and 50 degree.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. Sir, in the second one, since sec theta is 1 upon cos theta, can we do like cos theta equals to minus 1 upon 2 to find the angle?
Can you repeat that again?
Since sec theta is 1 upon cos theta, so if we
yes.
take cos theta, will it be minus 1 upon 2 then?
So sec is 1 upon cos, this is going to be y plus pi upon 2 in the denominator. That is equal to minus 2. Now, what is your question?
So if we're bringing cos on top, then we can change the right-hand side to minus 1 upon 2, right?
Yes, we can.
Okay. So can you explain part B because I'm getting two different answers?
Sure. So in part B, we are going to first of all alter the range. The range of y was from 0 to pi. So for y plus 2, it is going to be pi upon 2 to 3 pi by 2. Then just for my simplicity, this was y plus pi upon 2. Just for my simplicity, I can call this angle A. So A is between pi by 2 and less than 3 pi by 2. And I can call this angle as A as well. So cos of A is equal to negative 1 upon 2. Now I'm figuring out where is cos theta negative in the second and in the third. So the basic angle is going to be 6.
Pi by 3. Yeah.
So the right angle for A is going to be this and this. So pi minus pi by 3 and pi plus pi by 3. These are the angles for A.
Oh,
so
okay.
pi minus pi by 3. Yeah.
Okay.
Done?
Yes, sir. Sir, can you do the first part? Because I keep getting it wrong.
Sure. So you have been asked to prove sec x times cosec x minus cot x equals to tan x.
Yeah.
Now, secant x, if I take hint from the right hand side, I know that I need to come up with the simplification of sin x over cos x.
Yeah.
Secant x is 1 over cos x. Cosecant x is 1 over sin x. Minus cot x is cos x over sin x.
Yeah.
So 1 upon cos x sin x minus cos x upon sin x. If you take the LCM cos x sin x, you need to multiply this with cos x. So 1 minus cos square x is sin square x. So sin square x can be written as sin x into sin x upon cos x into sin x. You can cancel this out and you get sin x over cos x, which is tan x.
Okay. So in B, would we have to make the equation similar to the one in A?
So in for the second part, you need to use the result from part A. Okay. So if I want to solve this, secant x cosec x equals to 3 cot x, I can replace secant x with tan x. So you can just write tan x equals to 3 cot x. Did you get it?
But wasn't there a minus cot x on the left side in the first one?
Oh, yeah. My bad. Sorry. Then this is going to be secant x cosec x minus cot x. So you can subtract cot x on both sides.
Okay.
Secant x cosecant x equals to 3 cot x. You have been given this. If you remove cot x from both sides, okay, so okay, the left side could be written as tan x, and 3 cot x minus cot x is 2 cot x.
Yeah.
And cot x is 1 over tan x. So tan square x is going to be equal to 2.
Okay.
So tan x is going to be plus square root 2. And yeah, tan x is going to be equal to negative square root 2.
Okay.
You can find the angles of x from here.
Okay.
Hello. These are the answers.
Okay. Yes, sir, I'm done. I'm getting the same ones.
All right.
Sir, I'm done with this one. Sir, is it 0 and 360 degrees for the first one?
Just a second, let me check.
Okay.
These are the answers.
Sir, could you
check your work? You mind?
I'll check the
work. Yeah, sure. Okay. You check first. If you want, I can solve it for you.
Okay. Yeah, sir, could you explain this? Because I'm still getting it wrong.
Sure. So this is going to be 2 upon sine x plus 7 upon cos x equals to 0. 2 cos x plus 7 sine x over sine x cos x equals to 0. When you multiply this with 0, you're going to be left with 2 cos x plus 7 sine x equals to 0. Now, 7 sine x, 2 cos x is equal to negative 7 sine x. Sine x upon cos x, if you divide both sides by cos x, you're going to get minus 7 10 x, and 10 x is going to be minus 2 upon 7. Did you reach it here?
Okay. I reached it from steps before and I got confused.
Okay, from here you are going to solve for 10x. 10x is negative in the second and the fourth quadrant. So the basic angle that I'm going to get is 10 inverse of 2 upon 7, which is 15.9 degrees. So this angle and this angle are going to be 180 minus 15.9, that is 164.1, and 360 minus 15.9, that is going to be 344.1. Now I want you to take screenshots. We are done with question number 5. I want you to take screenshots of these further. So from question number 6, 7,
sir, could you go to the one you were on before this?
Like this? You want the previous question as well?
Okay.
And these are the questions as well.
Okay.
And these are the answers.
Okay, take.
Okay, I'll see you in the next class. Take care. Okay. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.